got the apps. We have not enough books, unfortunately. So please refer to the apps. The books can be shared with those who doesn't have the apps. And then after that, we'll have dinner, inshallah. Dinner will be served in a pack. So you may choose to eat over here, or you may pack and bring it home. And after that, inshallah, pray Isha. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا في ليلتنا هذه بما رضيت به عن عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد الحمد لله وذ الله بركة سبحانه وتعالى all of us here tonight. And all of us, of course, know why we are here tonight, especially because all of us, all of you came with love to celebrate, to remember the most blessed moment in humanity's life, which is the birth of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The birth of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was the birth of akhlaq, the moral character, the mercy, gentleness, kindness, love, compassionate, help, support, changing ideologies from root to good, from bad to great, having friends and brothers, not only the brother or the sister whom your mother gave birth, but those whom they match you in belief. To understand more about humanity and your contribution towards humanity as well. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu arzah, karam Allah jah, said, this is all when we say any sahabi, ahadu sahaba or ahlul bayt or any of them have said something, that mean this is what he have learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from that school, because the greatest school in our life is the school of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he was the principal of that school, and who was the student? The Sahaba or Ahlul Bayt radiyallahu anhum. And you can see how this school made it. Of they are great people that have graduated from this school, and they have done their part. And for more than 1,000, almost 1,450. 56 years from his birth, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I'm talking. We can see there are lots of great names, great stars in the sky of Islam, alhamdulillah. And whoever, any great name you hear about them, whom they have contributed to belief or to humanity, those people, those all of them, they are the fruits from the tree of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Through his teaching, through his way of life, through his sunnah, through taking him as our example, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you find the excellent example. Not full stop. You have to continue the verse. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. For those whom they hope Allah, closeness to Allah, and the goodness of the last day, the hereafter. وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And for those whom openly remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he's our excellent, how to do that? How to practice our life, not only by praying five times, but doing all the time something good for others to be praised. And end of the day, that praise, the good name, Sayyidina Rasulullah will share it with us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we make sure that our life, we have to do all good things. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will share it with us to make him happy, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he's a, as we see sometimes when we talk about families, if you see a very good boy or a very good daughter, or a girl, helpful, kind, polite, you will say, the parents. We straight away relate to the parents, correct? All right? So Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to see, for all the Muslims to see, and for all humanity to see on him the good example of everything, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The father, the leader, the friend, the companion, everything, alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is the main reasons for us to get together to celebrate Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we say something very important. The significance of remembering of his noble birth, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, can be only appreciated by the one who knows his greatness, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when you say celebrating Milad, there are some people, very little, alhamdulillah, nowadays it's getting lesser and lesser. This because more open-minded and open-hearted, right? They will understand that. Majlis, Mawlid al-Rasul, when the people get together, talking about Sunnah, Sirah al-Nabawiyyah, talking about Rasulullah, his moral character, his akhlaq. And that's what we need nowadays. We need to have a good families, great families, supportive families, happy life. We have to have homes, not houses. We don't want to be homeless in our houses. When there is no communication between family, no closeness within them, we have to make it home. Sakina, tranquility. And that's why Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it to happen. People before, they're complaining. If they lost something, small thing. When he came, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught that the meaning of the life and hereafter, the meaning of Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana, wa fil akhirati hasana, wa qina azab an-nar. The concept have changed. He taught them the meaning of shukr, when Allah give you, and sabr, when there is test for you. And that test not for nothing. And you shouldn't only say, oh, you are tested. No, you have to understand what the meaning of test. Who the one who tested before us, the Prophet, Al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen, he himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was tested from the day one in his life, alayhi salatu salam. He was born, they say, Al-Ulama, Al-Sirah, he got orphans three times. He's orphaned in three ways. He was born and his father was not there. So he's orphaned from the father's side. Correct? At the age of five, he have lost his mother. So he is now lost the mother. Then at the age of eight, who adopted him to look after him, I mean? Abdul Muttalib, his grandfather. Because, you know, you need the kindness and the support, the moral support when you are too young. When we grow, you will learn from life. The life is a school. But when you are too young, there is someone have to put you in the school of this life. When you are already in the school, you know how to study. Correct? So his father was not there. The mother passed away at the age of five. And Abdul Muttalib at the age of eight. So the one who looked after him all the way from A to Z, from the beginning to the end of the life, not his life, end of our life, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Yaqub alayhi salam and Sayyidina Yusuf, I always mention this story. When Sayyidina Yaqub has existed and he has sons, but what happened? They rejected the brother, their own brother, Sayyidina Yusuf. They took him away from the father and he went, you know. If Sayyidina Yusuf remained with his father, the story, he didn't go, the most he will be as a shepherd also, looking after sheep, because that's their business. But Allah took him away. No one doesn't know where. They doesn't know where is he. And he also didn't search of them. Allah made it like that. But he came back to them as a prime minister of Egypt, the most powerful country at that time. Because this is called Al-Inayatul Ilahiyya. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's looking after him. We have to teach ourselves, our children, that we are doing our part. But the biggest part is Allah's part, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa ma tawfiqi illa billah. All what I've got, all my support, all my victory, all my help is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to teach our children that, so that they know, they will understand the meaning of tawakkul. They know why they say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, why they say Assalamu alaikum, why they say Alhamdulillah, why they greet people. How these all qualities which we find in our life, and Alhamdulillah, we are the nation who have this high standard of these qualities. See, every day, how many people say Assalamu alaikum? Huh? How many say Wa alaikum assalam? How many say Bismillah? How many say Alhamdulillah? This is the whole world zikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here and there and everywhere. And this is all through the teaching of Sayyidina Mustafa sallam, who was just, who was the one who looked after him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen to this very carefully. He was born in Mecca. Mecca, very tough place. Very tough, very tough people. Those whom they go to Hajj and Umrah, they can understand that very well. Very tough, not easy to deal with. But of course, those days, the you talk about the Iman part, they have no belief. They are not Ahl Kitab. They are not Christian or Jewish, believe in Allah. They are totally unbelievers, mushrikeen. And 571 years after Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, the prophet before him sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was born sallallahu alayhi wasallam. 571 years. Imagine, no messenger after Sayyidina Isa, no Nabi, nothing. Until he was born sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Till he was born. Then add to add 40 years of his blessed age, 611 years. No zikr, nothing. Disappear. Gone. And he came environment of Mecca, tough people, everything is, the moral character is no more there. The weak will be eaten by the strong. The rich is mean rich, the poor is mean poor. So it was really very bad situation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all of that, he sent him as what? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً. We have sent you as a mercy, because the people always like mercy. And you are the example. I have sent you as and with akhlaq, moral character. They will see that on you and they will understand who you are. So he was born in Mecca, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The names of Ahl Mecca, subhanAllah, if you learn names, Murra is mean bitter. Sakhr is mean rock. Harb is mean fight. Jahl, something like, but Allah chose for him name Muhammad. Ajib. His father, Abdullah. Not Abd Manat, not Abdullah, not Abdul Uzza, Abdullah. I mean, say Allah is mean Allah, that's all. His mother, Amina. Ajib. The one who received him when he was born, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his name, Shifa. Then, the servant who look after him, Thuwaiba, yani from good deeds, like, you know, the one who breastfeeding him, Halima. What mean? It means sabr with kindness, hilm. Yani when you sabr, you can't be patient like that, but you sabr with smile. This is what I call hilm, with kindness. So Halima, Ummu Ayman. Other one. So all the people around him, subhanAllah, the name's been chosen and the quality also have been chosen for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See, his wife, Khadija. These, I mean, good friend, like, you know. His daughters, his sahaba, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. All. So, ajib, ya akhi, all the names. And so you can imagine the ball of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was something very special. Allah chosen for him. And when he was born, the Arab, those days, because you know, all statues are, when they got a child, baby, they will go to any Hubal, Allat, Al Uzza, and they put there and say, this is from you. And so Abu Abdul Muttalib, what he have done when they got the news and they brought to him, he go around Ka'batullah Tawaf. And he say, I seek your refuge in the Lord of this house to protect this boy. Ajib. So, ajib, the story of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was like amazing. Iblis alayhi la'na al-mal'oon, he have grieved with sorrow, you know, four times they said in riwayat, when he was cursed by Allah, number one, and when he was sent out from to the earth, and when Rasulullah was born, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a deen of oneness, tawheed already. Khalas. The deen is where they link the heaven with earth. The deen where Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have made such a great work that even the angels want to see him. So what happened? Isra wal Mi'raj. Great. Akhi. The story of Sayyidina Rasulullah, Sirah Nabawiyah, so great. Each have something very powerful and grateful meaning. Great meaning. That's why we sit, sometimes we sit, sit with your children. If you're able to, just mention little bit of something about Sirah Nabawiyah and what moral out of that we get. But you have to put in their mind, imagine someone like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who got all support from Allah, and he's Sayyidul Anbiya, Khatamun Nabi, Rahmatullah, with all of that, he suffered. But the moral here, how he faced the suffering and how he made it, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The quality of the people there, for example, they dislike girls. If someone, news came to him and say he was blessed with a baby girl, it's a crisis for him, a big crisis. So before anyone know, he will go and bury that girl alive. Al-maw'uda, wa'idha al-maw'uda tusu'ilat bi'ayyi dhanbin qutilat azam. Sayyidina Rasulullah changed this whole camp's concept 180 degrees. He taught them the meaning of having girls, for example, daughters. And he said to them, whoever has three daughters and look after them, raise them in the best way, they will be a reason for him to enter Jannah. So in the religious narration, one Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, how about someone who have two daughters only? He said, the one who have two daughters and look after them in the best way, until they, you know, raise up them in the best way, they will be for him reason to enter Jannah. Then one said, Ya Rasulullah, how about you have only one? Before they doesn't like, now. Huh? He said, that's also, if you look after, it will be for reason for him to, it will be a shield for him against Jahannam. He himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah bless him with what? Those whom they are alive, only daughters. Sayyidina Fatima, Sayyidina Zainab, Sayyidina Umm Kulthum, Sayyidina Ruqayya. That's the Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life and how he changed the life. He came in environment all, they believe in slavery, slaves. Each one person have 10 slaves. Can you imagine? At that time, he came to said, closeness to Allah, and someone commit a sin, someone do something. For him, tawbah nasuh, you have to free slave. So freedom of slaves, his aim, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he made it, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's a, this is a kindness to all humanity. Yeah, he, the slave is what? Someone who have no deen, maybe nothing, but he say, do it. This is our life, the human. And he taught them how to be. As-sahaba radiyallahu anhum, but satisfied with what they have. Mus'ab bin Umair radiyallahu anhu, Sayyidina Mus'ab bin Umair, he's the only son for his mother. Example. Ahl Mecca. And the mother was very, very wealthy. And he entered to Islam. He was very kind with her, but she was very angry with him. Sayyidina Mus'ab bin Umair, when he was very young, when any traders come from Yemen, from India, from anywhere, they bring the cloth, the textile or whatever, the silk, the best silk, they will go to him because he's the best buyer. Any amount, they will, a perfume, anything he will buy. So when he touch it, he said, silk, pure silk. He said, a bit rough, you know. You have softer than this. When he passed away, radiallahu anhu, subhanAllah, when he passed away, the Islam, I taught him this is the zina, the most important cloth. وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ. The dress of piety, the best, is how the people looks like to what you wear. They have should look to how you behave. So Sayyidina Mus'ab bin Umair, his kafan, if they cover his head, his feet, his legs will appear. If they cover his leg, his head will appear. That's a, but he was not concerned about all these things. They concerned about what I'm going to take with me to the next life, not what I'm going to leave back with me. And the people will ask, when someone left this world, they will say, how much he left? Sahih? The angels will say, how much he have taken with him, taken there. Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani has a beautiful saying. He said, give sadaqah if you are able to, because the kafan, the white cloth, has no pocket on it. You cannot take it. And he said, you are unable to take your money with you to the next world, but for sure you can send it ahead of you. When you do any good things, you send ahead of you there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much you'll give? One, the minimum, 1,000. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, he have done something great. He taught us the meaning of belief. He taught us the meaning of brotherhood. This brotherhood is something which really, really we have to work hard for it. Here you came from different backgrounds. India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Turkey, Afghanistan, from Sri Lanka, from many places. But all of us, we share many things together, in fact. How to be a Muslim, what we should say to enter Islam, to say I'm Muslim. La ilaha illallah. All of us. How many number of times we pray? 5 times. What are they? Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Hajj, same. Qibla, same. Everything same. That's the meaning of jama'ah and brotherhood. That's his aim, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he went, the first day he entered to Medina, Yathrib, there were two tribes there, Al-Aus wal Khazraj. They used to fight for centuries. For centuries. They kill each other. Bloodshed between them. What he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first day he entered, he met the brothers. Say, no more. So they become ukhwa, and he called them Al-Ansar. Alas, you are Al-Ansar. And they are proud of that. And Allah mentioned their name in Quran, Al-Ansar. And what else? Al-Ansar, Al-Muhajireen, came from Mecca. You are also brothers. That's innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa. Brothers. Brotherhood. That's what Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will be very happy to see people talking to each other. And before Sayyidina Bilal, when he was a slave, he was nothing. Bilal Habashi, from Habasha, Ethiopia. Nothing, zero. When he became Islam, he was a first person who prayed at the first line, and he's also he the one who called for prayer for Muslim to come. Become Muadhin al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salman al-Farisi, radiallahu anhu. Suhaib al-Rumi, Sahaba, great, ajib, ya Allah. Sayyidina Rasulullah made something very amazing. Why? See the Quran, what the Quran tells us. How to prove that you are a good Muslim. What your belief should be. In Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 136, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُولُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وما أنزل إلينا وما أنزل إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب والأسباط وما أوتي موسى وعيسى وما أوتي النبيون من ربهم لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون. Which means, say, O believers, we have believed in Allah and what has been revealed to us and what has revealed to Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Jacob, and descendants, and what was given to Musa and Jesus, Isa, and what was given to the prophets from their Lord. We make no differences between any of them. And we are Muslims. That is our deen. They believe in all prophets and their messages, and the beauty of their messages, because all prophets' messages is so beautiful. And Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came as what? To conclude the whole thing. We know about prophets, messengers of Allah, more than anyone else. Many of us know the stories of Sayyidina Ibrahim and Ismail. Sayyidina Hajar, Sayyidina Yaqub and his son, Sayyidina Yusuf. We know, because what? This is all the barakah of our deen and the mercy of the deen which was sent through Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we celebrate Milad, we are celebrate all good qualities in of our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do that. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In Surah Yunus, verse 58, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُ. Say, Ya Rasulullah, يعني يا محمد, in the bounty of Allah and His mercy, in that let them rejoice, let them show the happiness. فَلْيَفْرَحُ. Bounty, فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ, and His mercy. We don't know any rahmah greater than Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةَ الْعَالَمِينَ. So that's how why we celebrate this rahmah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why all the people before they will get together to sit together to talk about him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After Sayyidina Rasulullah passed away, as-Sahaba radiyallahu anhum used to say to Sayyidina Hassan bin Thabit, the poet of Sayyidina Rasulullah, Hassan bin Thabit. He was, one day he was giving poem in the masjid after Rasulullah passed away. Sayyidina Umar came and he said, Ya Hassan, why you stand here and giving talk like that? So Sayyidina Hassan said to him, Ya Umar, the one who made me stay here and give the talk and praise him and talk about him is better than you, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the one who said. So Sayyidina Umar, Sahaba used to quote Sayyidina Hassan, he said to him, remind us of Rasulullah. Let's talk about the poem, how he described him, how he, ajib, yani, ya akhi. And one of his poems, very, very famous, he said, وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَ قَطُّ عَيْنِي. Better than you, my eyes haven't seen. I've not seen. وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَ قَطُّ عَيْنِي. وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء. More beautiful than you, more handsome than you, than ever the mother can't give birth anymore. خلقت مبرئا من كل عيب. You've been created in a such way that there is no fault now on you. كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء. As look as you've been created as you wish, as you like. صلى الله عليه وسلم. عجيب. The way he talks, Allah sallam, the way he walk, the way he sit, the way he is not. Sometimes when people said, eat like that, that's the way of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We said that eating one part, but see how he used to sit and eat with humbleness, Allah sallam, the way he used to sit. He eat with whom? He would love to eat with the simple people and poor people. And he will immediately answer the call of the invitation of the simplest man among his people. Even though he is very poor, he will be happy to accept his invitation. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Great. Great. That's why Rabi'ul Awwal is a special month. Rabi'ul Awwal is a month of muhibbin. Everyone looking for Rabi'ul Awwal. We always talk about now the month of Rabi'ul. If our children will ask any brother or sister, say your son, he say, okay, in Dhul Hijjah we have Hajj season, Ramadan we have like, Sha'ban we have like that. In Rabi'ul Awwal, what we have? You say the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that itself, if they also say, okay, tell me about the birth of Rasulullah. Yeah, tell me about the Mawlid of Sayyidina al-Mustafa. What are you going to say? No, we cannot, you know. Please be kind. If you lose your mind, don't lose your heart. We have to be very careful, especially with the new generation. We have, if you want to good for them, is not to send them only to study in the best universities or schools or give them best food or cloth or phones. The best thing we can do is to link them and connect them with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That will be the best. Whatever, anything, when they love him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would like to be like him. They would be gentle like him. Bil mu'minina raufur rahim. If someone say, I am the follower of Sunnah, I say, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, bil mu'minina raufur rahim. Gentle and merciful, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Are you like him? Are you gentle? Are you merciful like him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? If you don't, yeah. If not, yani. Don't, we have to be special. We have really to be special so that we can enjoy being Muslimin, Muhammadiyin, I will call it, the followers of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, in our life, we can see that everywhere in houses, for sure, there will be Muhammad. The name is there always. Muhammad, Ahmed, Hamid, Mahmoud. Okay. If not his name, there will be enough of his Sahaba, or the name of his Ahlul Bayt, or the name of Tabi'een, or the name of Anbiya. Who is the one who told us and taught us about all these things? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, in indirect way, that each of our children, they name Muhammad, in fact. Because of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you say, your son name Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman or any names is because of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah, this is something which is very amazing. Very amazing in our life. And we have to try to keep it alive all the time. Each of us will have his own style to teach. The way. You can always make use of any incident and use it in order for you to teach yourself, your family, whoever, you know, about Sayyidina Rasulullah's life. In any incident in our life, you will find something related to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to teach us. Humbleness, tawadu, kindness, love. How he exchanged the love of the people. When he entered Medina, Sahaba, you know, the children of Al-Ansar, they're very young, all of them. They were like, when he crossed a very narrow road, with Sahaba with him all. So all of them, they were looking from the windows of the doors or outside. The kids, girls and boys, all of them. So Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was looking to them all. They were very happy. So he was saying to them, do you love me? Subhanallah. They said, yes, Ya Allah, we said, I love you too. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ajeeb, yani, yeah, what is this? Yani, you can't be proud of that. You wonder, who's the one who asks someone, his followers nowadays, to do you love me? Or he say, I love you all. You know, he, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he makes them like, feel they're great. The great person is the one in his presence, make you feel he is great. But the greatest personality, whom in his presence, make you feel you are great. And that was Sayyidina Rasulullah. At Sahaba, all of them, they will get something. He will look to the, when he give talk, he will look to their eyes. And he talks. So everyone will be alerted like, One day, Amr ibn al-As, Sayyidina Rasulullah was looking to him during, he thought maybe like, he's, because you know, so he went to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, Ya Rasulullah, am I better than Abu Bakr? He said, no. And he make him feel that he's, am I better than Umar? Am I better than Uthman? But what that meaning of it is that he give the people, make them happy and satisfied. You know, that's, the eye contact is very important also, the people. And Sayyidina Rasulullah, when the Sahaba, they look to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they got the barakah, the opportunity to shake hand with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to sit with him, to look to him, alayhi salatu wa sallam. There's special for them, because when they look to his eyes, they will see, oh, these eyes have seen something very special in Mi'raj. The hand have touched something. The blessed feet have stepped in somewhere. So no one can reach. And that just make you feel proud that you are a follower of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What that meaning, he said, be with me. Do as I want you to do for the goodness of your dunya and akhirah, with the kindness, with love, with patience. And one day you will see all of that. With me this time. With me, he will. So Sahaba, their concern is not to be in Jannah. The love, they don't love them. Their love is not to be in Jannah, that's all. They love to be in Jannah with Rasulullah. Yawmul Qiyamah, Ya Rasulullah, that Sahabi, when he said, Ya Rasulullah, about Judgment Day, When is judgment day? He was a bit tired, look pale face, very, he's getting thinner, they were slimmer. So Sayyidina Rasulullah asked him to come. He said, what's wrong? I mean, Ya Rasulullah, I mean, I'm just thinking about judgment day. Yawm al-Qiyamah. Why you think about Jahannam? He's Shafi' Rasulullah, so he won't think about that. Ya Rasulullah, you will be there in a different place, very high. I cannot see you like now. Huh? So Sallallahu Alaihi said to him, what you have prepared for that day? He said, the love of Allah and His Rasul. Right away came. The love, he's in heart, khalas, in his heart, in his tongue, immediately. Sayyidina Rasulullah, don't worry, you will be with the one whom you love. But this hadith has two meanings, in fact, beautiful meanings, two way. It's a two way, it's not only one way. We said, our love to him, how about his love to us? Huh? So when he said, you will be with the one whom you love, yani, if it's not because of our love to him, we will be with him because of his love to us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah, this is Allah's barakah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to enjoy each and every moment in our life when we think about him, and we think of how to apply his life in our life. We need it now more than any time. The division happening in our ummah because of the lack of understanding to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If anyone, very simple way, if any of us wants to face, if you, anyone facing any issue in his life, he say, okay, if Rasulullah in my position, what he's going to do? Someone has argument with his wife, with his mother, with his boss with the, you know, if you are a boss with your, they work under you. What he's going to say and how he, see Sayyidina Rasulullah with his servant, who was not appointed as a servant, Sayyidina Anas. No, he was asked for it to be with Rasulullah. Not like say he appointed, I give him salary. No. So Sayyidina Anas, 11 years with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not a single time he said to him, no. Never say no. When he apologized, like someone gave me a cup of tea, I say, no, Haji, thank you. But he won't say no. This no is not there. Only way he say, no God but Allah. La ilaha illallah. Huh? How he apologized, he just like, thank you so much, I'm fine. I appreciate it. And the way of saying, all the way. That's why you can imagine a Sahaba, they have adopted this quality, and you can see that in their life. Subhanallah, and ajeeb. We, all of us, don't say no. Huh? All of us have special love to our wealth. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. We love our wealth, extreme love. صح ولا لا? Don't say no. Huh? Right? See how Sayyidina Rasulullah made it for them. When Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, during his khilafah, every day, every night after Salat, Isha, the people go back home. He won't go to his house direction. He go a different direction. So Sayyidina Umar was wondering, why he go from that side always? So he followed him one night. He saw him come to one house, very humble house, very simple in the side of Medina. Yeah, and that, if you say side of Medina, when he walk, how long will take walking? Maybe 1 or 2 hours. In the sun, in that weather, you know, and coming back also. When I say someone say, how far your house? Say 1 hour. I say, I mean 2 hours. Going 1 hour, coming back 2 hours. So he meant 4 hours, for example, right? At that time. But for him, there's something called himma. Al-himma, he won't think about all this. He will think how to please Allah, that's all. And they say, al-ajr ala al-maqam, how much you will receive, how much you suffer for, you know, struggle, let's say, you will receive great reward. He went to, he saw him, he spent time in the house and came out. He went to the house later, knocked the door, and blind women came out, old women. Salaam alaikum, wa alaikum salaam. May I know? He was asked how you live. He said, we are, you know, very poor people. I am looking after 3 orphans. Both parents passed away. Both. So I'm the grandmother, like, you know. Say, how you live? Like, how? Say, every night, alhamdulillah, someone come. I doesn't know who. He don't mention his name. He come and he cook the food for us, feed the children, put them to sleep, and he wash the everything, clean the house, even wash their clothes, and he go back. Now we understand. He say, Ya Bakr, the one come after you will be very tired. Didn't know that he's, and it happened later. Sayyidina Abu Bakr passed away. When he used to go to the house, he would take with him plate of dates, tamr, kurma, kajur, every night. So Sayyidina Umar that night went, he took the dates. And he went to the, he gave her, he said, my friend cannot make it. So he send you this dates. And I will help you in the house, he said. I will do that. So she took the dates, had one, and said, he send it, these dates? He said, yes. So I think, no, he didn't say, no, no, he sent. He said, no, I think he passed away maybe also. So how you know? He said, because whenever he bring the dates, it's seedless. He will remove the seed even. Gentleness within gentleness. Generosity within generosity. This is all related to what? Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of them like that. Ajeeb ya akhi, their life. Read about them, Sahaba, their life and how they made it. This is Allah's barakah for us. Now we understand why we celebrate Mawlid. I don't know if someone doesn't love to celebrate Mawlid, how he loves Rasulullah then. Part of his blessed life, most of important part of his blessed life is his birth, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The birth of all prophets, many of the prophets Allah mentioned Quran, Sayyidina Zakaria, Sayyidina Yahya, Sayyidina Maryam, Sayyidina Yahya, Sayyidina Isa, Sayyidina Ismail, Sayyidina Musa, about their birth. Wassalamu alayhi wa multi, salamun alayhi wa mawlida, peace upon them. When it comes to Rasulullah, you know? But this story, as I said, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, nowadays is gone. And anyone who argue with, how come? You know the way sometimes the people, very, those whom they have this block-minded, right? They are like, ah, bro. I say, look, brother, if you are right, don't be angry. Huh? And if you are wrong, you have no right to be angry. Right? The whole ummah, the majority of ummah, 99%, they are as those whom they celebrate Mawlidul Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one day when he's standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on judgment day, Allah says, why you celebrate the Milad? Like we now today, we are celebrating the Milad of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will ask all of us in judgment day, and in the presence of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah says, say, why you celebrated the Milad of my beloved? See the way, the beloved, Habibullah. Say, ya Allah, because we love him. Ya Rasulullah, because of love, I love you. We say, okay, go to Jahannam. Cannot be. Al-mar'u yuhshar ma'amil. Say, okay, go with him. That's what we want, alhamdulillah. So inshallah, with this barakah, we have, most importantly, to kill the language of hatred and enmity. Because this is the language of shaitan. Read in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 91. إنما يريد الشيطان أن يوقع بينكم العداوة والبغضاء. He says, Shaitan only wants to cause between you enmity and hatred. Any stories of enmity, hatred, someone have ideas, someone extreme thoughts. And you see, the one who have extreme thoughts, I mean extreme mind. Extreme mind won't work. Because our deen is a deen of rahmah. I cannot compare it like that, I mean. Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is always like cool. Nah. He makes people happy. A boy, the brother of his servant, Sayyidina Anas, brother of his servant. He lived in the other part of Medina, quite far away. And he was telling him, how is your family, Anas? So he said, Allah, alhamdulillah, Rasulullah, except my brother, the younger brother. What happened to him? He's very sad. He cried. Why? He has a bird, and the bird died. Now he cried, he's very sad. So bird and boy. What Sayyidina Rasulullah said, come, let us visit him. Allah, ajeeb, ajeeb. Go all the way from that side to that. He won't say long distance. Go all the way, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is rahmat al-alameen. That's the way of Sayyidina. Make it easy. Everything, there is ease in everything. The intention of going, what? Al-a'malu bin-niyat. He won't think about distance. He will think about what? About the blessings of it. About the lessons for all of us. He went all the way. So when Anas said to him, today, this is your Eid day, and like this is a day of, so he said to his brother, do you know who's coming to visit you? Rasulullah himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he know that Sayyidina Rasulullah coming to visit him, he was so happy. And he come running towards Sayyidina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he hug him, and he was crying, ya Rasulullah, my bird, I've lost my bird. Yeah, boy, you know, he's. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained with him until before Fajr. But when he left, the boy was a smile and laugh. He spent all this time. Now we have many people. If you cannot visit them, they have any issues, we forgot sometimes even to message them. Huh? Ya akhi, the life become too easy, but we make it difficult for us for the next life. We are not using what we have in our hand, these phones, for goodness. These phones cause broken families nowadays. It's because it's being misused. Make those whom they are far close, but they made those whom close far. Use your phone unless you have something. If don't use it unless you have something, work to do or something. All right, that we understand. But if a boy with a family sitting with them, you know, playing, when he's going to have time for parents? In China, I saw one video clip. A Chinese family went to a mall to buy an iPad to their son. And the salesman, they were all of them excited to buy it. The salesman said, this iPad for whom? They said, to this boy. Say, his age? They said, 7 years old. He said, no, this is not for him, not for sale. This is only for age of 14 and above. So they say, what? Say, this age now for family. When he reach 14, then you buy this for him. Don't, you know, wallahi, good advice. Yes, how many of us have these qualities now to look after the children, to look after, you know, most of the problems, miscommunicating. Sometimes father cannot play the role. The mother is playing that role, alhamdulillah, to connect the family, which is great. And I think this Allah have given the mothers 3 times reward more than, you know, because of Allah wants them like that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants them to be rewarded, the highest reward, with their mercy and gentleness. And can you imagine this one mercy in the hearts of the mothers? And Allah left with him 99. But Allah wants still to show this mercy. So he sent us rahmatan lil. How much the mother have mercy, Rasulullah have lots of mercy, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And how he advised the people, someone come to him, say, Rasulullah, I have my mother, I look after her, I clean her, I wash her, I do this, I do that, I feed her, I took her to Hajj, I carry her on my back, I took her to Hajj. Am I done a little bit good for her? He said, no. You have not paid back to her, even the one shout when he was delivering you, you could not pay back that to her. Subhanallah, Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he, in the way, one day, Medina, from Medina, he went to visit his mother's grave. Sahaba, subhanallah, said when he, in the front of the grave, he cried and made everyone cry. Subhanallah, how many years, and she was, you can't remember, you remember her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But how many years? But the way that he cried looks like she just passed away. Like he made all Sahaba felt mercy for him, grief. Who is the one who taught us these qualities of looking after parents and mothers and fathers and looking after children? That's all Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we are within this field, alhamdulillah, every day we are able to celebrate Milad, inshallah. The minute you do anything, and you know that Rasulullah love it, and because of this love, you will be close to Allah, you will be rewarded. Don't lose this opportunity. Our deen is full of rewards, full of love, full of mahabbah, full of good qualities. These qualities for us and for others to see. We don't want to see like broken families, Muslim broken. This one, you go to a police station, then I don't know what. No, that shouldn't be. And these all related to raising up and following up. Raising not only khala gone, later on also, after. Because they are our names. If someone, you see Zayla Luqman, he was advising his son, who was not too young, quite, you know. And because now the time he's a hikmah, he wants to give him the hikmah, how to deal with all situation of his life, to be great, to have a good name. If you want a very great advice, in the Quran, he say Luqman and his son. This is in Quran. How many of us knows about this story? And sometimes we read stories, how you see anyone want how to, my son naughty or my daughter or something, we go to internet, Google, what to do with our children like that. You got someone, I don't know, he think he is, you know, but leave that, you go to Quran and see. Luqman, the story of Luqman. The story of Sayyidina Maryam when she was, how the mother was to, the story of Sayyidina Musa. Wallahi ajeeb, these are all the prophets, messengers of Allah, the stories that which we're going to get. The reward, number one, because of Kalamullah. Number two, we please Allah by doing that and see what's going to happen to the families after that. With full of tranquility and barakah, inshallah. May Allah grant us all barakah for dunya and akhirah. May He allow us always to celebrate Mawlid Rajab every year and our situation getting better and better as a family, a brotherhood, as a relation, as a neighbors, at every, anywhere we live. Whenever anyone prays us, remember the prayers also with Sayyidina Rasulullah will share it with. Make sure that you will bring this good name for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make sure you're going to do that so Rasulullah will be happy. If you did something, he won't be happy, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if he's not happy, Allah won't be happy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us to do our best, to be best parents, best children, best teachers, best students. The qualities of our life to be changed is not only what to eat and what to drink, but what we can keep with us here and in later life, in a hereafter, inshallah. May Allah grant us al-barakah fi al-dunya wal-akhirah. Allahumma aghfir lana wa rahmna wa samihna wa tub alayna wa rida anna bima radit biha an ibadika al-salihin bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin wa ila hadrat al-habib al-mustafa sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala sahbihi al-fatiha. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد. الحمد لله رب العالمين. And brothers and sisters, as we may again just remind you that every Monday and Wednesday we have programs here, inshallah, 8 o'clock. Shama'il Muhammadiyya, the blessed appearance of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every Monday and Wednesday. Whoever have time and feel the distance is not too long for him, ahlan wa sahlan, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. Now we will recite together Mawlud Diba'i. The Mawlud container of Salawat and the biography, the Sirah Nabawiyya. We want all to share with us. We have a books, I think, but it's not enough. And we have sent a WhatsApp message with a PDF of Mawlud Diba'i. For those whom they have it, they can use it, inshallah. It'll be easy. جزاكم الله خير. Anyone, there's chairs behind for those whom they are unable to sit, please use chairs, because be here until subuh. Inshallah, we just read the part of...
Extra mic.
Okay. Either Farjad and other brothers, you know, the Omar and I were here, Hamdi. إلى حضرة الحبيب العظم سيدنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وأصحابه وأمته الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين
الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي بلغه الوسيلة
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي خصه بالفضيلة
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارضى عن الصحابة
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارضى عن السلالة
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارضى عن المشايخ
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي فارحم والدينا
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارحمنا جميعا
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارحم كل مسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واغفر لكل مذنب
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي يا سامع دعانا
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي لا تقطع رجانا
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي بلغنا نزوره
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي تغشانا بنوره
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي حفظانك وأمانك
لك يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واسكننا جنانك
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا رب أجرنا من عذابك
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي
وارزقنا الشهادة يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي حطنا بالسعادة
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واصلح كل مصلح
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واكفي كل مؤذي
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي نختم بالمشفع
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر ويتم نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما وينصرك الله نصرا عزيزا. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك
عليه وعلى آله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
صلى الله عليه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله القوي الغالب الولي الطالب الباعث الوارث المانهي السالب عالم الكائن والباين والزائل والزاهب يسبه الآفل والمائل والطال والغارب ويوحد الناتك والصامت والجامد والزائب يضرب بعدله الساكن ويسكن بفضله الضارب.
لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله. حكيم أزهر بديع حكم العجائب في ترتيب تركيب في ترتيب ترك مستغفر هل من تائب
تائبون إلى الله.
هل من طالب حاجة فأوني له المطالب فلو رأيت الخدام قياما على الأقدام وقد جادوا بالدموع الزواكب والقوى بين نادم وتائب وخائف لنفسه يعاتب وابك من الذنوب إليه هارب فلا يزالون في الاستغفار حتى يكف كف النهار زيول الغياحب فيعودون وقد فازوا بالمطلوب وأدركوا رضا المحبوب ولم يعد أحد من القوم وخائب.
لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله. فسبحانه تعالى من مالك أوجد نور نبي محمد
صلى الله عليه وسلم
من نور قبل أن يحلك آدم من التين اللازب وعرض فحره على الأشياء وقال هذا سيد الأنبياء وأجل الأشفياء وأكرم الحبائب.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
كلا هو آدم
عليه السلام
قال آدم به أنله على المراتب. كلا هو نوح
عليه السلام
قال نوح به ينجو من الغرق ويهلك من خلافه من الأهل والأقارب. كلا هو إبراهيم
عليه السلام
قال إبراهيم بهم به تقوم حجته على عباد الأصنام والكواكب. كلا هو موسى
عليه السلام
قال موسى كوخ ولكن هذا سبيب وموسى كليم ومخاطب. كلا هو عيسى
عليه السلام
قال عيسى يبشر به وهو بين ندي نبوته كالهاجب. كلا فمن هذا الحبيب الكريم الذي ألبسته هلة الوقار وتوجته بتجان المهابة والافتخار ونشط على رأسه العصائب. قال هو نبي صرخته من لؤي بن غالب. يموت أبوه وأمه ويكفله جده
ثم عمه الشقيق أبو طالب.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. يبعث من تهامة بين يدي القيامة في ظهره علامة تزله الغمامة تطيعه السهائب. فجري الجبين ليلي الذوائب ألفي الأنف ميمي الفم نوني الهاجب. سمعه يسمع سرير الكلام بصره إلى سبع اتباك الثاكب. قدمه قبلهما البعير فأزل ما اشتكه من المهن والنوائب. آمن به الدب وسلمت عليه أشجار وخاطبته الأهجار وهن إليه جزء هنين هزين النادب. يداه تزهر بركتهما في المطاعم والمشارب. قلبه لا يغفل ولا ينام ولكن للخدمة على الدوام مراكب. إن أوزي يعفو ولا يعاكب وإن خوسم يصمت ولا يجاوب. أرفعه إلى أشرف المراتب في ركبة لا تنبغي قبله ولا بعده لراكب. في موكب من الملائكة يفوق على سائر المواكب. فإذا ارتقى على الكونين وانفصل عن العالمين ووصل إلى قاب قوسين كنت له أنا النديم والمخاطب.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. ثم أرده من الأرش قبل أن يبرد الفرش وقد نال جميع المارب. فإذا شرف التربة طيبة منه بأشرف قالب سأت إليه أرواه المهبين على الأقدام والنجائب.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعليه. فسبحان من خصه صلى الله عليه وسلم بأشرف مناسبي والمراتب. أحمده على ما مناها من المواهب وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له رب المشارق والمغارب. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث إلا سائر الأعاجم والأعارب صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أولي المآثر والمناقب. صلة وسلام دائمين متلازمين يأتي
قائلهما يوم القيامة غير خائب. اللهم صلِّ وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
صلى الله عليه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أول ما نستفتح بإراد حديثين ورد في نبي كان قدره عظيما ونسبه كريما وصراطه مستقيما قال فيها قيما لم يزل سميعا عليما إن الله وملائكته
يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. الحديث الأول عن بحر العلم الدافك ولسان القرآن الناتك أوحد علماء الناس سيدنا عبد الله بن سيدنا العباس رضي الله عنه الرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال إن قريش كانت نورا بين يدي الله عز وجل قبل أن يخلق آدم
عليه السلام
بألف عام يسبح الله ذلك النور وتسبح الملائكة بتسبيحه فلما خلق الله آدم
عليه السلام
أودع ذلك النور في دينته قال صلى الله عليه وسلم فأهبتني الله عز وجل إلى الأرض في زهر آدم
عليه السلام
وحملني في السفينة في صلب نوح
عليه السلام
وجعلني في صلب الخليل إبراهيم
عليه السلام
حين قذف به في النار ولم يزد الله عز وجل ينقلني من الأصلاب الطاهرة إلى الأرحام الزكية الفاخرة حتى أخرجني الله من بين أبوي وهما
ما لم يلتقيا على صفاح قط. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل عليه.
الحديث الثاني عن عطاء بن يسار عن كعب الأحبار قال علمني بالتوراة إلا صفرا واحدا كان يختمه ويدخله الصندوق فلما مات بي فتحته فإذا فيه نبي يخرج آخر الزمان مولده بمكة وهجرته بالمدينة وسلطانه بالشام يقص شعره يتزن على وسطه يكون خير الأنبياء وأمته خير الأمم يكبرون الله تعالى على كل شرف يصفون في الصلاة كصفوفهم في القتال قلوبهم مصاحفهم يحمدون الله تعالى على كل شدة ورخاء ثلث يدخلون الجنة بغير حساب.
اللهم اجعلنا منهم.
اللهم اجعلنا منهم وثلث يأتون بذنوبهم وخطاياهم فيغفر لهم وثلث يأتون بذنوب وخطايا عظام فيقول الله تعالى للملائكة اذهبوا فزنوهم فيقولون ربنا ربنا وجدناهم أسرفوا على أنفسهم ووجدنا أعمالهم من الذنوب كأمثال الجبال غير أنهم يشهدون أن لا
إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. فيقول الحق معزتي وجلالي لا جعلت من أخلص لي بالشهادة كمن كذب بي أدخلوهم الجنة برحمتي يا عز جواهر العقود وخلاصة إكسير سر الوجود مادحك قاصر ولو جاء ببذل المجهود وواصفك عاجز عن حصر ما حويت من خصال الكرم والجود الكون إشارة وأنت المقصود يا أشرف من نال المقام المحمود وجاءت رسل من قبلك
لكنهم بالرفعة والعلا لك شهود.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
أحضروا قلوبكم يا معشر ذوي الألباب حتى أجلو لكم عرائس معاني أجل الأحباب المخصوص بأشرف الألقاب الراق إلى حضرة الملك الوهاب حتى نظر إلى جماله بلا ستر ولا حجاب. فلما آن أوان ظهور الشمس الرسالة في السماء الجلالة خرج مرسوم الجليل لنقيب المملكة جبريل. يا جبريل نادي في سائر المخلوقات من أهل الأرض والسماوات بالتهان والبشارات، فإن نور المصون والسر المكنون الذي أوجده قبل وجود الأشياء وإبداع الأرض والسماء أنقله في هذه الليلة إلى بطن أمه مسرورا، أملأ به الكون نورا وأكفله يتيما وأطهره
وأهل بيته تطهيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
فاهتز الأرش طربا واستبشارا وازداد الكرسي الهيبة ووقارا وامتلأت السماوات والأنوار ودجت الملائكة تهليلا
وتمجيدا واستغفارا. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر.
ولم تزل أمه ترى أنواء من فهره وفضله إلى نهاية تمام حمله، فلما اشتد بها الطق بإذن رب الخلق ودعت الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم
ساجدا شاكرا حامدا كأنه البدر تمام. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا نبي سلام سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك يا نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام الحسن تفاق
يا رسول
يا
الله وصلاة الله تغشى
أشرف الرسل
محمد
يا الله
ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي
يا الله
ببركة الهادي محمد
يا
الله وسلام مستمر
يا الله
كل حين يتجدد يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي
يا الله
ببركة الهادي محمد
يا
الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي
يا الله ببركة
بركات الهادي محمد يا الله
هلا البدر علينا من ثنيات الغدا وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا صلي وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جعلنا الله وإياكم ممن يستوجب شفاعته ويرجو من الله رحمته ورأفته. اللهم بحرمة هذا النبي الكريم وآله وأصحابه السالكين على منهجه القويم اجعلنا من خيار أمتي واسترنا بذيل حرمته واحشرنا غدا في زمرته واستعمل ألسنتنا في مدحه ونصرته وعنا متمسكين بسنته وطاعته ومتنا اللهم على حبه وجماعته. اللهم أدخلنا معه الجنة فإنه أول من يدخلها وأنزلنا معه في قصورها فإنه أول من ينزلها وارحمنا يوم يشفع للخلائق فترحمها. اللهم ارزقنا زيارته في كل سنة. اللهم ارزقنا زيارته في المدينة المنورة في كل سنة ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين عنك ولا عنه قد رسينا. اللهم لا تجعل في مجلسنا هذا في ليلتنا هذه في شهر ربيع الأول هذا أحدا إلا غسلت بماء التوبة ذنوبه وسترت برداء المغفرة عيوبه. اللهم إنه كان معنا في السنة الماضية إخوة وأخوات رحمهم الله منعهم القضاء عن الوصول إلى مثلها فلا تحرمهم ثواب هذه الساعة وفضلها. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا من أصحاب القبور ووفقنا لعمل صالح يبقى سناه على ممر الدهور. اللهم اجعلنا لآلائك ذاكرين ولنعمائك شاكرين وليوم لقائك من الذاكرين وحنا بطاعتك مشغولين وإذا توفيتنا فتوفنا غير مفتونين ولا مخذولين واختم لنا منك بخير أجمعين. اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين. اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين. اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين واجعلنا من فتنة هذه الدنيا سالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا الرسول الكريم الحبيب لنا شفيعا وارزقنا به يوم القيامة مقاما رفيعا. اللهم اسقنا من حوض الكوثر حوض نبيك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا واحشرنا تحت لوائه غدا. اللهم اغفر لنا به ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا وللجماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات ولآبائهم ولأمهاتهم ومشايخنا ومشايخ معلمين وعلميهم وأزواجنا وأزواجهم وذرياتنا وذرياتهم ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنة الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات وغافر الذنوب والخطيئات يا أرحم الراحمين. You may ask Allah now for your own and private dua إن شاء الله.
ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، ولا تؤاخذنا بالعظائم والجرائم يا كريم. إلهنا مولانا تقبل دعانا منا، واجعل طوافك الخفي في كل أمورنا، واجعلنا من الذين سبقت لهم منك الحسنى. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وإلى حضرة النبي المصطفى سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وأصحاب أمتي وعلى ذنية بسر الفاتحة.
الرحمن الرحيم.
سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منا ومنكم. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah bless you all, inshallah. One before we pray Isha announcement.